Okay, so we are going to switch adapt this bubble machine. We've got a handful of basic tools. We've got some wire cutters and wire strippers. I've got a drill with a 1/4-inch drill bit, and I have a soldering iron that we will be using. We'll also need a screwdriver, but there is a screwdriver that comes in here that could be used, but I find one with a slightly larger handle works better. But you can always get by with the one in the box. So let's get started. Let's open it up. We're going to be careful to save all of the packaging because we want to be able to package this back the way it came. So we're going to pull this out. And as you can see, here's that smaller screwdriver that I mentioned that is used for putting the battery in. We'll set that aside because you'll see that it actually works sometimes a little better than our screwdriver, our big screwdriver. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to open this up. And get this out of the packaging. Again, we're going to save all of the packaging. On the back, there are 6 screw holes around the outside, as well as one holding the battery compartment. We don't actually have to take the battery compartment off to open this up. So first thing we're going to do is take out these 6 screws. Being very careful to make sure we don't lose any. All right, once we have the 6 screws out, we're going to carefully remove the front and we're going to set that aside for now. The other thing is this piece in the middle, if you just hold lightly and pull, it pulls right off. All right, now we can get to the business part. So we're going to set this orange piece aside as well. All right, so taking a look inside of here, we need to find how we get from power through our switch. So our switch is up top, and if we look, we can see the switch is very delicately soldered on. And so this piece actually comes off if we want to, but I'm just going to leave that in place. Because I think rather than try to solder directly to the switch, because those wires are just very tentatively attached, I can see that they're just barely attached. I'm going to solder to the points where the other end of those wires. So I can either solder to this end of this wire or to this end of this wire. And for the black wire here, I can solder up to the switch or I can solder down here. So soldering to these 2 points instead of to the switch itself will work exactly the same as if we had soldered to the switch, only those points look like those wires are already much, much more firmly attached, and so we're less likely to destroy the toy. The other thing we need to do is figure out where we're going to put our jack. So I think we're going to put the jack, we could theoretically put it somewhere on the front, but in order to do that, we're going to start to get into this orange housing, and we don't want to do that. We can do it down low here, but then we're getting into this battery compartment, so it's going to be far better to put it on the back. And looking here, it looks like this side of the back is going to be better than this side of the back. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drill a small hole. I'm going to use my 1/4-inch drill bit, and very carefully drill a hole. Now, here we go. I'm going to drill into this backing board so I don't destroy my mat, and I'm just going to come in here. I'm going to press. And then there we go. We have a hole. And then we can confirm that our jack fits because I was guessing at the size of the drill bit. I'll set that nut aside. Oh yeah, that's going to fit nicely. Perfect. All right, so we're going to set that aside for now because we're not going to fasten it to the hole yet, but we just wanted to know where it was going to go because I need to now cut wires that are going to extend from those 2 spots, one from here to here and one from here to here. So I'm going to get some wire and size it up to the approximate length. And a little longer is better than a little shorter, so from here to here, I'm going to do about this long. And then for my other wire, I have to go from that motor to down there. So again, just a little longer than I need. It's going to be easier to work with, and I'm going to go ahead and cut that off. All right. And now I need to strip these wires. So this is 22 gauge stranded wire that I'm using. I prefer stranded wire for this sort of operation because it takes the solder better. So I grab my wire strippers and I go to the 22 gauge section and I strip a small piece off of each end of each wire. The other thing I'm going to do once I've done that is I'm going to tin the wires with a little bit of solder. So I'm just going to put a little bit of solder on each end of each wire. This will just make it easier to solder to once I get my wire in place. It'll make it a little easier for everything to go. So I'm going to twist that up a little bit and then just heat the wire very gently with the soldering iron and then touch the opposite side of the wire with the solder. And if the wire is hot enough, it should just melt and coat the wire. Not so bad. And I'll just do all four ends of my two stripped wires. Same way, just touching the wire and then the solder is being touched to the opposite side, and when the wire is hot enough, the solder will flow right towards that soldering iron. If you get too much solder on the tip of your soldering iron, off the camera edge there, I've got a little sponge that I'm wiping the little damp, very damp, very lightly damped sponge that I wipe the soldering iron on to clean that tip up. The other thing that's going on with our solder is this is called rosin core solder, and that means that there is a little bit of stuff in the solder to help it stick. And that rosin is a little corrosive, so we always want to make sure that we have fully cleaned our soldering iron when we are done, because that'll help preserve the life of our soldering iron tip. We just tin all four ends and then we will be good to go. So having a little bit of extra solder on the wire will make it much easier to solder it to the components in our bubble blower. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to grab our jack and we need to solder to it. Now we'll notice there are actually three points of attachment, and we're going to need to attach to the bottom one and the top one. So those are the two outer ones. We won't be using the middle lead at all. So the two outside ones, so which will be the top connection and the bottom connection. Now it doesn't matter which wire goes to which one. Positive or negative does not matter. So we're just gonna hook this in there. I always like to bend it over a little bit to give it a little bit of a mechanical connection so that it holds tightly if it gets yanked on slightly. So we're just going to put that in the helping hands, and then we are going to solder it. So you can get away without helping hands, but if you've got them, always a good idea to use them. So we're just going to come in with the soldering iron. We're going to heat that up. And again, the solder likes to stick to whatever's hottest. So if we touch the solder to the same side as where the soldering iron is, it won't really do the job. So you'll notice, here we go, see how it's all jiggly? We don't want that. It needs to not be jiggly from the wire. It should be firmly attached to that wire and not jiggle at all relative to the wire. So we got to do that again. So let's hook that back in there, and then we will make sure we get it this time. So we're gonna heat that up, make sure we're heating, and then we're putting the solder in from the opposite side. The solder will flow towards the soldering iron, and then we can move it around a little bit to make sure that solder is attached to both the wire and the metal. And now you can see that the wire and the metal move as a single unit. And now we're gonna solder on the other one. So we did the top one, now we're gonna do the bottom one. So again, we're avoiding that middle one. That one won't help us with our mono jack. So I'm gonna try and get that in there. All right, so sometimes I find I have to crook the wire a little bit and makes it a little easier to get it in there. So, yep, definitely got to put a little crook in it. So I'm going to bend it slightly, and then it'll be a little easier to stick in there. And then also I can bend it around that crook to get me that mechanical connection. And sometimes it helps to have a pair of pliers. These wire cutters, wire strippers actually have pliers on the end that I can use. They're not the greatest, but they do work. And so I'm going to crimp that over, and we're going to then solder that in place. And again, I'm going to hold that in my helping hands, and we'll heat that up and bring a little extra solder in. Again, coming in from the opposite side of the connection with the solder, so the solder will just flow right on in, and if everything's hot enough, it'll stick nicely. Pull away, let it cool for a sec, and then, yep, the blue wire and the jack are soldered. They move as a single unit. So now we're going to pop that in. Actually, we're going to solder our wires, and then we're going to pop it in. So I'm going to touch this wire onto that solder pad where the red wire is soldered on. Now that red wire is just sitting in that solder. So we got to be careful that we don't let it fall away. So we're going to heat up the solder that's already there. And that'll also heat up the solder that's on our yellow wire that we put on there when we tinned it. And we're just going to get it all together. We're going to pull the soldering iron away first, let it cool just a little bit, give just a light tug to both wires and see that they are firmly attached. Now we're going to do the same thing with our black wire. So our negative lead. So we'll get it in there approximately close, careful not to burn ourselves, and then we're going to heat that up, get all that solder good and melty, let it cool, still holding everything still. It doesn't take long. And then give our wires just an ever slight tug to make sure that they are attached. Now we're going to push this through our hole, and we're going to grab that nut and secure the audio jack to our housing. Very small. Helps if you got small fingers. We're going to tighten that down. Now, I like to always test. So I don't want to put it all together and have to take it all apart again. So what I'm going to do next is we're going to test it before we do anything else. So we're going to find that screwdriver, and we're going to take off the battery compartment, and we are going to drop our batteries in and make sure it still works. So hard pulling things apart sometimes. All right, I'm going to pop those batteries in. And push the button. So on, off, great. It still turns and it blows air, perfect. The other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to grab an assistive switch, and we're going to plug that in also and make sure our jack is soldered appropriately. So grab my jelly bean switch here, and I'm going to plug that in, and then push. Oh yeah, works great. Perfect. Now I know that we're good to go, so I can finish putting this back together. So I'm going to grab the front and that orange piece and bring them in. Now we're going to put the orange piece back on first, and when we're lining it up, sometimes it's a little difficult, and so we're going to be very careful, and we're going to double check, make sure our gasket is centered. That gasket has to be centered, and then it'll fit a little better. Once we get that snapped into place, I like to test it again, because sometimes things aren't quite aligned, and it's easier to deal with now than before we put it back in. So we can feel some air blowing out, and we can see the green thing spinning. We are good to go. So now we just have to put it all back together. Well, or test it with our assistive switch as well. Yep, still works, air still blows, and it still spins. Now we can put that front back on. And we can secure our six screws, and then we are good to go. We just have to package it up, and that is our assistive bubble blower.